Welcome everyone, my name is Cloé and I'm going to present you how social behaviors impact parasites burden. Gastrointestinal parasites are common in equids and are transmitted through contact between the mouth and the environment, for instance while grazing. Its repartition is heterogeneous within a group. A study of 2012 shows that in wild zebras group, 20% of individuals are carrying 80% of the parasite burden of the group, the dominant being less parasitized. Nevertheless, all individuals are equally treated with anthelmintics in captive conditions, leading to an overdosing of the medicine and the loss of its efficiency due to a selection of naturally resistant parasites, as illustrated here with the red triangles representing the anthelmintic treatment. In this study, we investigated how hierarchy affects host parasite dynamic in a French Mediterranean safari park, the Réserve Africaine de Sigean, to improve the future management of parasites of captive plain zebras. This study was conducted from February to July 2019 using fecal analysis to evaluate Strongylidae nematode and coccidia parasites intensity by counting eggs and oocyst shedding. All individuals were daily observed during 10 minutes by focal sampling method. Agonistic behaviors were used to evaluate the group's hierarchy with the David score method, and the higher is the DS score, the more dominant the individual is. All behaviors, including a contact between the zebra's mouth and its environment, were used to calculate a contamination risk index. We designed it based on behaviors frequency and an index from 0 to 3 attributed to each behavior depending on the estimated risk of parasite transmission. Zebra were treated with anthelmintics against Strongylidae parasites, so we divided the results in two parts, before and after treatment. Our results show that the more dominant is an individual, the older it is and lower is the contamination risk through social behaviors. Strongylidae prevalence is about 95% before treatment and 55% 3 months after treatment. One zebra, the most subordinate, shows no significant differences of parasite burden before and after treatment, and then was individually treated later. There is no correlation between parasite burden and behaviors before treatment. Nonetheless, subordinates carry more strongyle than dominants and show a higher risk of contamination through social behaviors after treatment. Coccidia's burden is independent from other variables. However, during the entire study, coccidia's burden dynamic was significantly opposed to strongyle burden dynamic. Our results after treatment are consistent with previous study about wild zebras. 20% of individuals corresponding to the most subordinates are carrying 70% of the strongyle parasites burden. Contamination dynamic within the group could be observed only after anthelmintic treatment, as prior treatment all individuals were highly contaminated. Previous studies show that dominant horses have more access to high quality and parasite-free food, while subordinate horses tend to avoid foraging in dominant feeding areas. Since anthelmintic is mixed with parasite-free pellets and distributed daily in free access to all animals present in the enclosure, dominant wild zebra probably have more access to non-contaminated food and anthelmintics, explaining the parasite burden distribution within the group and the lack of efficiency of the treatment for the most subordinated zebra of the enclosure. Moreover, our results lead to the conclusion that social behaviors also impact parasite transmission, since subordinate individuals have the highest contamination risk index and the highest parasite rate. All our results suggest that parasite management of plain zebra in safari park could be applied to specific individuals, such as subordinates. Selective treatment should then reduce safari park ecological impact and improve enclosure gestion by protecting the ecological functions performed by coprophagous insects. This study opened to a new perspective of research. Further studies could explore the dynamic of coccidia infections in captive plain zebras through reduction of anthelmintic use. Also, Briard and Endelwa recently brought up the need of identifying high contamination risk behaviors in order to understand the mechanisms linking social behaviors and parasitism. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me through my email address.